Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you a few circuits you can use to detect if an analog signal changes its power level. So in this tutorial, which is rather short, I will be showing you a rising edge detector, a falling edge detector and a dual edge detector. So just to demonstrate it, a rising edge detector gives a dual edge detector gives a short output signal if the signal strength increases, as you can see here. And if the signal strength decreases, the falling edge detector and of course the dual edge detector give a signal and not the rising edge detector, as you can see here. Of course this works also if you increase or decrease it in more than one power strength. And well, so much for the demonstration. Now for the space you need, the rising and the falling edge detectors are basically on a 2x3 platform. The dual edge detector I'm using here is a simple butt switch here, you can see, and needs pretty much only a 3x1x1 space. Of course this is just one possibility for a butt switch. There are countless other ones out there, so if you have some space issues where this doesn't work, you can also use another butt switch, and well, then you need other space requirements. Okay, now what will you need if you want to build those circuits, those detectors? Of course some kind of building block. Then for the rising and the falling edge detectors, it's each 2 redstone and 3 comparators. And for the butt switch I'm using, it's 1 sticky piston, 1 slime block and 1 redstone block. As you can see here. Good. Now that you know what you need and how much space you need, let's start with the building. Okay. As you can see, I already prepared a few things. An analog input with 5 different levers I can use to manipulate the analog signal, and 2 platforms for the rising and the falling edge detector, and 1 point where the dual edge detector will be built, and also a few lamps as an output. Okay, so now let's start with the rising edge detector. For this you will need a 2x2 platform. The input will be this point here and the output will be where the lamp here is. Now grab your comparators, place 2 like this, a 3rd like this, the 3rd you put on the subtraction mode, then 1 piece of redstone here and finally a normal block here. And as you can see, if I turn on the power, this lamp gets powered for a very short moment, and if I increase the signal strength, each time I get a signal to this lamp here, but if I decrease it, it doesn't happen. Okay, so now for the rising edge detector, the falling edge detector, you pretty much build the same circuit here, only flip this comparator here by 90 degrees. So in this case this point here is the input, then we have our 2 normal comparators and our 3rd comparator in the subtraction mode, then our redstone and the block here. And now as you can see, if I increase it, the rising edge detector works, but if I decrease it, the falling edge detector gets a signal. Okay, now last thing to do is the dual edge detector, and although there is a possibility or a way to combine those two, the rising and the falling edge detectors, it's much easier just to use a simple butt detector or a butt switch. The reason for this is, well, the change in the signal strength of a redstone wire also contributes to a block update, which then triggers a block update detector. And as you can see, every time I change the signal, doesn't matter in which direction, if it gets stronger or weaker, every time I get the signal. Of course, this is just the easiest or cheapest but you can build nowadays. Of course, every other kind of but would also work. So this is just a little example for you to give you a little idea. Okay, one last thing I want to mention before ending this tutorial. Make sure that the analog input here doesn't lock your but switch. In this case, make sure that the redstone line doesn't run directly into this piston here, or a block adjunct to this piston here. So this but can work all the time. Okay, but nevertheless, now this is the end of this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and well, see ya.